Water reboiling is a very classic experimental phenomenon. It typically appears in water boiling experiments. The most classic operation is after completing the water boiling experiment, remove the heat source, then seal the flask tightly with a cork, turn it upside down and pour some cold water on top. The water inside will then reboil. But why does it reboil? Let's analyze this carefully. First, after turning it upside down, the top part is sealed, trapping some air inside as well as water vapor that has evaporated. These are all very hot. If cold water is poured on top, the gas inside not only cools and contracts, but the water vapor also cools, condensing into white mist. This causes the gases at the top to suddenly decrease significantly, meaning they suddenly become less dense. Or, in other words, the air pressure suddenly drops, and we know that air pressure is related to boiling point. If air pressure suddenly drops, then the boiling point of the water below also suddenly drops. If the boiling point drops below the actual temperature of the water, then the water becomes superheated, so it naturally boils again, and it boils very violently. It's a kind of explosive boiling. So option A allows water to reboil. Option C is similar to this. It also involves turning the flask upside down, but replaces cold water with ice cubes. Reviewing our analysis process, you'll find ice cubes work too. The cold water or ice cubes simply serve to cool things down, making the water vapor at the top cool, causing it to condense significantly, lowering the air pressure above. So option C works as well. There's another similar operation. Does pressure reduction only rely on cooling? Actually, no, option D is another method. It directly connects a tube at the top, then uses a syringe plunger to extract air. When you remove the gas, the air pressure naturally decreases, air pressure drops. The boiling point also drops. It can similarly cause reboiling. The only option that won't work is option B. It also uses cold water, but it sprays cold water in the wrong place. Previously, we sprayed cold water toward the gas, to cool the gas, to condense the gas. This lowers the air pressure, lowering the boiling point. But here, cold water is sprayed directly onto the water. All you're doing is lowering the water temperature. With lower water temperature, it becomes even harder to boil. So option B doesn't work. The answer is option B. Did you learn from this?